Hello and welcome to another Lumbridge Night Guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this guide, we're going to go through everything to do with range. So keep watching if you want to unleash your inner Robin Hood. First up, we're going to look at quests, as quests are usually an easy way to get a skill boost. Unfortunately, in free-to-play, you are extremely limited. There is only X marks the spot, which offers you a 300 XP lamp that you can use for range. I personally wouldn't, but it's up to you if you want that 300 XP head start. Following that, let's look at starter kit and stats. Now for me, I do not want to be a range pure in free to play, as in just pure range and nothing else. You definitely need some defense levels. I recommend minimum 40 to allow you to wear green dragon hide eventually. You'll need 20 to wear studded and 10 to wear hard leather. Obviously, standard leather, you can wear from level 1. Ironman, you're probably going to need level 18 crafting in order to wear standard leather. This is because you just can't buy leather band braces, leather body, or leather chaps anywhere in the game. So it's far easier just to get some cowhides, tan them in Algorid, and craft them yourself. So you're going to need 18 crafting. You can do this in partnership with section 1, so gather the cow hides by killing the cows that I'm going to go through in the next section. As you can save spot the cows, it's not really that big a deal whether you do this before or during the first section. All in all, if you decide to do the crafting grind beforehand, you might want to get to level 28 and just craft yourself a hard leather body in advance, because that's the only way to get a hard leather body as well. Everything else I think we can buy. Or we have to buy, rather, because you can't craft them in free-to-play. Okay, so let's go through the equipment. I'll be flashing it up on the screen, but to start, you're going to need a short bow, a hard leather body, a leather cowl, leather boots, and leather vams. The hard leather body is obviously optional for Iron Man. I mean, you can skip the crafting altogether, because at section 2, we're going to buy studded leather once we hit 20 range, so that is up to you. Obviously, standard accounts can just buy these things from the GE. Anyway, an amulet of power if you can. This might be difficult for Iron Man, so an amulet of accuracy from the Imp Catcher quest. Link to a guide to that quest popping up on the screen right now. A cape, and obviously some arrows. You can get the starter arrows from the range tutor. Like the training bow and the short bow have the same stats, the same is true for the training arrows and the bronze arrows. So which of these you use is up to you. If you've got no money, maybe use the free ones. If you've got plenty of money, buy some bronze arrows, because they're more than good enough for now. Equally, here is a handy table on how to calculate your max hit. And for each of the sections going forward, I will give you an average of how many arrows you are going to use slash need per section. This is just a guide to give you an idea. For those who are interested in the exact technical details, your max hit is driven by your ranged strength, and in free to play this is very simple because your ranged strength is determined by the type of ammunition you're using and your ranged level. The second stat you want to be looking at is ranged attack bonus, and this is basically how frequently you will hit enemies based off of their defense. Affecting this is again your range level and your equipment, so things like van braces, chaps, etc. Better equipment, obviously having a higher bonus. Moving on to another key concept, there are three attack styles that you can use while attacking with ranged. These are accurate, rapid, and ranged, or long range. Long range, probably you don't want to use this. This is kind of a 50-50 split between defense and ranged experience, so you'll gain defense levels while doing this. It's probably the slowest way to train defense. You're better off just using melee to train your defense, in my opinion, but it's an option if you want to. Early on, from levels 1 to 30, you're best off using accurate, as this adds a plus 3 to the player's range level, which possibly increases the max hit. So you'll do a little bit more damage, and obviously more damage, more DPS. Once you pass level 30, you probably want to be using rapid, because it increases your attack speed by 0.6 seconds, which works out at about a 33% increase in how fast you fire your arrows, which roughly translates to a 33% increase in your DPS, potentially. After level 30, the advantages of accurate are quite minimal. Don't fret, for each section, I will indicate which attack style to use. Last quick tip while we're here, while you're at the range shooter, make sure you select the option to auto-equip arrows in the quiver. This just means if you pick up the arrows you've dropped, they'll automatically be put back in your quiver and just saves a little bit of time. As with all my videos, I've split them down into several obvious stages to hopefully make things easier to follow and easier to understand. So, training location one, I give you a choice of three actually. So we've got seagulls, cows or chickens. Whatever you pick here is your call. Seagulls are apparently the fastest, however there's a very limited number in Port Sarum, so they may not be as readily available. They also drop feathers, but not as prolifically as chickens, because there's far more chickens. Personally, I always go to cows, just because this lends in to what I mentioned earlier about training my crafting, because I need to get to 28 crafting so that when I hit 10 defense, if I haven't already, I can get my hard leather body. So that's why I'm gonna pick cows, as you can see on the screen. You can also safe spot the cows completely. Not that chickens or seagulls do a particularly high amount of DPS, but it helps to be able to safe spot, and the cows are completely safe spottable and non-aggressive. They also drop cow hides, which is obviously bonus for the crafting, and this is the only source in free to play for cow hides for Iron Man. So fill your boots, in my opinion. Get as many cowhides as possible. Right, so there's several upgrades at this point. When we hit level 5 ranging, we need to change to an oak shortbow. While I'm on the subject of bows, something that I haven't already mentioned is the difference between a shortbow and a longbow. Basically, shortbows will fire faster but have a shorter range. Longbows fire slightly slower but have a longer range. Now, in RuneScape, it basically offers very little benefit to have the increased range versus the increased fire rate. So pretty much always stick to the shortbows because they're just better. Simple as. If you disagree, please leave a comment and explain why. I'm as interested to know as I'm sure other people are, but from my research, shortbows are just the way. Equally, building on the table I presented in the first part of this guide, your max hit is a function of the ammunition you're using and your range level, so it doesn't necessarily matter what type of bow you're using. That doesn't really increase your max hit, it just allows you to use stronger ammunition. However, each bow offers an increased ranged attack bonus, which means that you're more likely to hit targets. In short, the better your bow, the higher your DPS is going to be, and the higher your DPS, the faster you're going to gain experience, which means the faster you're going to level up. Obviously refer to the table, because sometimes, depending on your level, certain ammunitions will do the same amount of max damage. On that note, you will need to kill 140 cows approximately to get from levels 1 to 20, and that's going to set you back around 224 bronze arrows. Once we've done cows for a bit, we should be level 20 range. At this point, we need to head over to Varrock and head into Horvick's, is that how you pronounce him? Horvick's Armory Shop in Varrock, and buy yourself full studded leather. As I mentioned previously, full studded leather will require 20 defense. Anyone who's got 32 quest points and can enter the Champions Guild, this is south of Varrock, can also buy a coif. I recommend you buy the coif also. Once you've finished upgrading your armor, you'll also need to head back to the archery store and buy yourself a willow shortbow. That kind of sums up this section. If you follow my guide, so we've got 40 defense, we've got 20 range now, and we're now rocking full studded leather, leather arms, a coif, a cape, amulet of power or accuracy, and leather boots, as well as a willow shortbow. Stage 2, we're now going to head west of Varrock to the Barbarian Village, specifically the longhouse you can see on the screen there. That is because plenty of barbarians spawn in this location, and it's actually difficult not to safe spot them, so it's really cool. There's also plenty of free meat that appear on the tables, so you get free food and easy safe spots. What's not to like? So I recommend you stay here from levels 20 to 30. From levels 20 to 30, you're going to need to kill around 118 barbarians, and you're going to need at least 166 bronze or iron arrows in order to do this. Once you hit range level 30, you guessed it, head back to Varrock and buy yourself a maple short from the archery shop.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Stage 3. This is for range levels 30 to 60, and again, it's a classic, the giant frogs. Now, there's a big jump from 30 to 60, so there's also a big jump in the number of frogs that you need to kill. So you're going to have to kill 2,831 frogs. Damn, that is a lot of frogs. But, I mean, the crazy frog deserves it. So, yeah, you best get to it. I recommend you continue using bronze or iron for giant frogs, of which you're going to need around 4,340 arrows. These are really good because they drop big bones, so they're good for training prey, and they also have really low defense with really high hit points. That means that for each frog, you get more experience for less clicks. And that is always the name of the game when I give you a guide. I'm trying to do the most efficient method for the least amount of clicks. These frogs are quite easy to save spot as well, so you need a minimum of food. And you can see the save spots on all my background videos. You can see there, I'm kind of showing you how to save spot. It's pretty simple. Anyway, hopefully that helps. Obviously, once you get to level 40, it's time to buy the beautiful green dehide armor. This can be bought in two locations. Firstly, you can buy the Vams and Legs, as well as a Coif, if you haven't already got one, at the Champions Guild. And then you can buy the chest from Ozaic. He is in Edgeville. You can only buy the chest if you've completed Dragon Slayer. Oh, and there's another link popping up on the screen to a guide of how to do Dragon Slayer. Okay, so I have read a few guides, so I'm just going to linger on this one for a little bit longer. And they kind of suggest that around this level, range level 40, and with the green dehide, you can kind of train on dark wizards to get some runes to prep you for magic training, which is kind of coincidental because my next video is probably going to be a similar guide on magic training in free to play. So if that's available, I'll stick a link there and you can check that out. If not, wait out, but this kind of links nicely in. But realistically, I don't think this is actually that great an idea because you need food. It's very hard to save spot. So unless you're really desperate for runes, I think you're better off following the next couple of stages, getting money and buying runes as you need them. But it is an option if you want a break from the giant frog onslaught. So maybe from levels 50 to 60, if you want some runes, you can go train on the dark wizards. They're probably slightly closer to a bank, but you will need food because you can't really safe spot these guys because the fire spells back at you basically. So I'm gonna end that there. Stage 4. Now this is for range level 60 to 70. You probably need steel arrows or above, and all of the equipment mentioned previously. Our next fort of choice is down in the Varrock Sewer. And what am I talking about? I'm talking about moss giants. From levels 60 to 70, you're going to need to kill 1,933 moss giants. So not as many frogs, but still quite a few. I recommend iron or steel arrows, preferably steel if you can afford them. And you're going to need around 3,600 of them to hit level 70. They can be safe spotted, which is really good, so you can take a minimum of food with you. Again, they drop big bones. They've got a crap ton of health. So these are really good training. And they also drop the Mossy Key, which you need if you want to fight Bryophyta. Bryophyta is one of two bosses available in free-to-play, so it's well worth we do that. And I'll mention it briefly at the end, but that is one of my things that I reckon you should work towards if you're going to train your range. And that, I mean, just about sums up Moss Giants. The nearest bank is probably the Varrock East Bank. I recommend taking teleport runes, having some magic levels advantageous, because then you can teleport out at least. You'll still have to run all the way back. When you're getting there, make sure you take a slash item so you can get through the spider web. And yeah, just rinse and repeat, getting your range to 70. Unfortunately, there's no other equipment that is better than what you're wearing, other than a full set of gilded dehide, which is like the gold dragon hide you might see people wear, but that's worth 26. million-ish on the GE, so Iron Man, you haven't got a chance in hell. And free to play, if you want to spend that kind of money, crack on, but yeah, they're quite rare items. So the fifth and final stage, designed to get you from range level 70 to range level 99, is a bit of a double act. The first part of said double act is the Ogresses. You can find these at Corsair Cove, just down the hall, and they're easily safe spotted. To be honest, they're not the best thing in the world to use ranged against, because they have quite high range defense, but as far as drops go in the free-to-play world, these guys probably drop the rarest stuff at the highest frequency. They're also the only place that you can get rune full helms as an Ironman, outside of the GE, I mean. These are the only guys that drop it in free-to-play, and the amount of rune drops, battle axes, rune meds, etc. you're going to get is pretty high. So they're pretty much the best moneymaker in the game, and with 82 hit points, they're really good AFK training. Caveat here, obviously, is that I would recommend trying to max out your top hit, which means using Mithril or Adamant arrows, which are obviously quite expensive. And just to give you an idea, if you went from 70 to 99 at the Ogresses, you're going to need to kill 37,491. So yeah, just a few. And that's going to require around 103k Mithril arrows. So on the GE, you're probably talking 300 to 400k, but poor Ironmen who probably have to buy them from the vendors, which increase their price as you buy more, you're talking like minimum 3.5 mil. So it's, it's going to be expensive if you're an Ironman. You can come obviously a lot earlier than level 70 if you desire, but the lower your range level, the more ammunition you're going to expend, because as I said earlier, these guys have really high range defense. How do you access these? All you have to do is actually just start the Corsair Cove quest, and another link can pop up there to a guide on how to do that. As I said, you only have to start the quest, you don't actually have to finish it. Personally though, I would strongly recommend that you finish the quest. The main bad guy in that is a magic user, so if you're at this level of range, you can easily kick his ass. That's not a problem. Secondly, it opens the bank, which will just make your life so much easier. So do that in your own time. And this brings me to the second part of this stage, which is just to alternate back to the moss giants, basically. So alternate between the ogresses and the moss giants from stage 4 all the way up to 99. And yeah, those are the best places and the best enemies to fight against for various reasons inside of OSRS free to play. That should get you all the way to 99 in a reasonably decent time. It's going to take you a long time. Unfortunately, that is the nature of free to play. The grind is real. That's a little bit of an extension to that last point. I kind of thought of a couple of little extras that might help pass the time, slash are just nice things to do anyway on a free-to-play account, but specifically you can use a bit of range to do this. First up, completing Dragon Slayer, as mentioned previously, in order to get Green Dehyde Chest. It's definitely just one of those things you need to get done, and it's a really good quest to be fair, so if you're in your questing, you'll enjoy it anyway, and it obviously gives you the ability to wear your full green Dragonhide. So it's a must-have to rock the best ranger setup. Secondly, from fighting all of your moss giants, when you start doing that, you'll inevitably get some mossy keys, so use them to fight Bryothida. I usually do like 5 at a time and then go fight her. She's also weakest against range, so as long as you've got some decent prayer, protect from magic being key, so that's level 37 prayer, she's actually an easy battle. And again, there'll be a link pop up on the screen there. If not, wait out, I am working on a guide for that at the moment. And the last thing I would recommend you do, purely because there's so many AFK slash easy safe spottable enemies within, is to build the Skull Scepter from the Stronghold of Security. The added bonus of that one is that you can also get a free teleport to the Barbarian Village, which is really useful. That's just something nice and useful to have. And that just about sums up this video. So I hope this has been of some use to you. Please leave a comment and let me know if you have any tips of your own. I'm eager to hear them. And this is the Lumbridge Knight saying peace out. So, peace out, guys.